at Pontius Pilate, the ruler of the court. After my wife's warning, I knew I should have nothing to do with the killing of this innocent man. I asked the priests, elders, and those of the crowd to give me the fault they found in Jesus. I received no other witness other than crucify him, crucify him.
Crucify him! Crucify him! Give us Barabbas! Give us Barabbas!
I became so overwhelmed with their senseless shouting that I took some water and washed my hands before the crowd, saying, I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves. Then the people shouted, his blood be on us and on our children. I released Barabbas to them. But shortly thereafter, Jesus was flogged and handed over to be crucified.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone, and welcome to another episode of The Prelude. Happy Palm Sunday to everyone as we prepare to celebrate the Holy Week, the crucifixion, the death, the burial, and the resurrection of our Savior. But we start today with honoring and observing Palm Sunday. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I am Minister Otis Byrd, Assistant to the Pastor for Online Ministry and Engagement here at the Alfred Street Baptist Church, and we are glad and excited to be here again with The Prelude. Remember, we're here every Sunday morning at 7:36 a.m. and 10:36 a.m., and we want you to come out and join us as we aim to intentionally engage with you, our virtual church family. Listen, you all know how we do it. Go ahead and put in your name, the city that you're from, in the chat box. We want to be able to shout you out. If it's not just you worshiping, put who's worshiping with you, whether it's mom, dad, your spouse, sister, brother, lottie, dottie, and everybody. Put them in the chat box. We want to shout you out and welcome you into this space. Well, you all know that there's always something going on in these Alfred streets, and if you've been following us, you know this month we have been in revival. That's right, March Gladness has been going on. We started the month out with the Reverend Dr. John Faison, then we had Reverend Marissa Farrow, and last week, you all, you missed a treat if you were not here, the Reverend R. Janae Pitts Murdoch. Bless the house, and guess what? We're not finished yet. We want you to join us on this Tuesday for the conclusion of the matter as we welcome the Reverend Dr. John Adolph all the way from Beaumont, Texas, pastor of the Antioch Baptist Church there. So listen, come on out as we continue to be revived. Listen, you all know how we do it on The Prelude. I usually don't come alone, and today is no different. But we have a very, very special guest, you all. The man, the myth, the legend is here with us today. The senior pastor of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, the Reverend Dr. Howard John Wesley is in the house. Welcome, Pastor.
Oh, this is good to be on. I never get to do the prelude. I'm always trying to get ready to preach.
Yes,
upstairs,
sir.
Praying, laying hands on the sick, raising the dead. But I'm so glad to be part of the prelude today to welcome our online family. You all mean the world to us.
Yes, sir.
We're so grateful to God that the church is much larger than our building, so we welcome you to worship today, and it's my joy to be on with you all.
Yes, sir. Let's shout a few people out. Let's see who we have worshiping with us.
Okay. We got, who's this from? We got Dr. M.D. Gallery from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Good morning, D.
Welcome, welcome.
Also want to welcome Dennis Key all the way from Queens, New York. Queens in the house. Welcome, 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 welcome. And we'll welcome Rashika Crudup, who's watching us from North Carolina as well, Franklinton, North Carolina. Glad to greet you all on this Sunday morning.
Absolutely. And we're praying for her because she's tuning in with her twins, Pastor.
Twins? In Jesus' name. I don't know what you did wrong, But may the Lord add a blessing to you each and every single day. God bless you for twins. Amen.
Absolutely. Welcome, welcome. Well, you all, we have another special guest with us. Today is Palm Sunday, but it is also our Easter pageant here at ASBC. And we are happy to have one of our Kid Street members join with us. And Pastor and him will have a conversation.
Hey, hey, hey. It is Palm Sunday. You all know that the Easter pageant is a rite of passage. If you're from a Baptist church, you got to learn your lines. You got to do the play. You got to tell the story of Jesus. And I want to introduce you to an amazing young man who's part of our Kids Street Ministry. Tell him who you are.
Hello, my name is Jonathan Brown, and I am 10 years old in the fourth grade.
Jonathan Brown is our 10-year-old. This brother can sing. Your dad
yes,
is a
sir.
Tremendous singer, and I understand you like to sing as well.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. So listen, today's the play. Can you tell us a little bit about it? What's going to happen? What role you have in it? What's going down today?
I'm super excited, and what's going to happen is I'm going to be singing in the choir today, and I am also going to be playing the role as Pontius Pilate in the speaking part.
Wow. How long have you all been rehearsing?
Sir?
How long have you been rehearsing?
Oh, a lot.
A lot, a lot. Yeah, yeah. Listen, with that kind of rehearsal and energy put into it, we know you're going to be blessed. Do me a favor. Make sure you reach out to family and friends. Tell them to log on today. This is not something you want to miss. To affirm and applaud our young people is the greatest assignment of the church. Listen, I want to let you know I'm proud of you, and I hope you do a great job today.
Thank you.
All right. We'll catch you.
All right, Jonathan, thank you for being with us. Thank you for being with us. You all know here at Alfred Street Baptist Church, under the leadership of Pastor Wesley, we take seriously the ministry to our youth and teens. So we're so glad and excited about their pageant coming up. So tune in, tell everyone, like, share, subscribe, and share, and let everyone know that it's going down at 11. Pastor, what do you think about the children's pageants? What excites you about that?
So being raised in the church, you know we had to do this.
Yes, sir.
But there's something to be said about learning to confidently stand, share the good news of Jesus Christ, to stand in front of a congregation that affirms you and applauds you. It builds confidence.
Yes,
it builds faith. It builds character. And there's no greater assignment the church can have than to build confident, intelligent, articulate young black men and women who are proud to be born again. So this is a joy for me to see some of these children that we just baptized, to see some that are growing among us, to know that one day they'll be part of our senior youth ministry on their way to college. Look, this is at its best. It doesn't get any better than this.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Listen, also, Pastor, you know, you, if anyone knows, there's always something going on in these Alfred streets. Talk to us about Holy Week coming up next week.
Yeah, there's a lot going on in these streets. A lot going on in these streets over here. We'll let you know that we've got our journey into Holy Week beginning. Every morning this next week at 7 a.m., I'll be leading our prayer time. I invite you to join us on Zoom for our 7 a.m. prayers every morning. We also have our noon devotionals. Every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, we follow in the footsteps of Jesus. We gather in this space and also online at 12 o'clock for about a half hour of devotional to reflect and contemplate on the suffering of Jesus as he made his way to the cross. Then on Thursday, we have the very special service of foot washing, 1 p.m. and 6 p.m. We grab a towel just like Jesus did, humble ourselves, and wash feet. On Friday, we go to the cross to hear the last words of Jesus from the sisters at the cross at 12 p.m. to hear some of the phenomenal preaching of the women of God as they remind us of what Jesus said as he left this life. Saturday is Silent Saturday. We're just getting ready for Easter Sunday. Sunday, Easter, 6 a.m. sunrise service right here. They say early in the morning. If you don't know how to do early, you ain't Baptist. Early on Sunday morning, we'll be here at 6 a.m. And then we'll go out to the Strathmore for our Easter service at 11. The doors open at 10. Dr. Judy will be preaching at 6. I'll be preaching at 11. And you're going to be blessed by both.
Absolutely. We're looking forward to it, Reverend.
And pray for me.
Yes, sir. We're praying for you. If you all have missed it, Pastor just ended a series last week, his Lenten series. That's what he said. I'm telling you all, it was a blessing. It was a blessing. If you need to learn how to turn the other cheek, go and check the lesson.
I'm still working on that one. Now, in Jesus' name. Some of the stuff God called us to do, we got to pray for. Amen.
Yes, sir. Well, Pastor, we have a little extra time on the prelude this morning, so we want to take advantage of that time, and we have Pastor here with us, so we want to have a little bit of fun. Is that all right?
That's right. I
and
love
we're
it. I love
gonna
it.
Have 10 questions with Pastor Wesley.
Oh, man, y'all didn't tell me. Okay, let's go.
Yes,
let's
sir.
Go.
Yes, sir.
And, first book of the Bible, Genesis. I got Genesis.
No. Here we go. First question. If you had to write a sermon strictly about your teenage years, that was just a few days ago, Reverend, what is that title?
The title for my teenage sermon would be, Thank God for Protection on the Prodigal Path. Amen. He keeps us when we walk down that prodigal path of life.
The prodigal path.
Sir. Yes, indeed.
All right. Question number two. This is perfect for you.
All right.
If you were singing a gospel duet, if you all don't know, Pastor Wesley is a gospel artist. We can't tell you the label he signed to. That's top secret.
I'm paid extra not to sing. But anyway, go ahead, man.
If you're singing a gospel duet, who is your partner?
Easy breezy. CC Winans. CC Winans, she's going to take me in. It's going to be devotional. I can let her lead most of the time.
Yeah.
But I love CC Winans.
BB, watch out. All right, here we go. If I see you are rocking, I see you are rocking a side part.
Yeah.
And so you know our producer Tiffany came up with these questions so that I can remain safe.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm taking it back to the 80s, man. Going back to the old school.
Okay, will we get another one on the other side for Easter?
No, we ain't doing a two-part thing. That there's something a little off with that. But you're doing both my ears appear, so I may bring back the double hoop earrings, you know, do the double hoop thing.
Bring
you know,
it back.
The guy, you know, from back in the day, but no, I probably not could do that. Probably not.
Yes, sir. Favorite film when you were growing up?
Wow, favorite film when I was growing up is either going to be the Rocky series or any of the Star Wars films. Love
you're
Rocky.
You're a Star Wars fan,
man. Love Star Wars to death. That defines my generation, man.
Yes,
and then, you know, I love Apollo Creed. You know, I love Mr. T. You know, my prediction, Pain. You know, ain't like a good Rocky movie. Not like a good Rocky.
Yes, sir. Let's see. Favorite actor?
Oh, man. My favorite actor, hands down, Denzel Washington. Love the roles he's played. Love the longevity of his career. He's passionate about his love of Jesus Christ, his wife. And there's nothing better than him playing Malcolm X.
Yes, sir.
He was cheated. He should have got the Academy for that year.
Wow. Yes, sir. And his son is a Morehouse man, by the way.
Okay.
Praise the Lord. All right. When you're reading, do you prefer a tablet or a book?
A book. I can't do tablet. I need to take notes. I need to write in the margins. I need to see it all.
All of that. The children are coming in. We're still going. What is the most interesting thing you learned recently?
The most interesting thing I've learned recently will probably be one of the toughest lessons of leadership, and that is that sometimes we have to protect the guilty, not just the innocent, but learning to protect the guilty is one of the most difficult things I've had to do lately.
Yes, sir. Two more. March Madness. Who is winning the tournament?
Oh, that's easy, boy. I'm a prophet. I declare and decree in the name of Jesus Christ, who rose again from the dead, that the Duke Blue Devils will put up another banner in Cameron Indoor Stadium. That is where God watches God's favorite team play basketball. In Jesus' name.
Y'all didn't know he spoke in tongues, did you?
I'm Pentecostal. Yeah.
And last question, who will they have to beat to win it?
In order for it to be great, we will take down the University of North Carolina. It's not really a legitimate school. It's about 8 miles away from Duke University, and there's no greater joy we have than to put the Tar Heels back in their wrongful place. So I would love to see Duke stomp on them Tar Heels, put up another banner, and my day, y'all could call me home to glory.
Yes, sir. Blue against blue.
Blue against blue. Well, that ain't a real blue. It's one of them kind of blues.
Yes, sir. Well, Pastor, let's shout out a few more folk and see who we have.
We got Sister Patricia Weiss from New York. Welcome, Sister Patricia.
New York
Glad
is in
to
the
have
house.
You on today. Want to welcome Minister Genesis Slaughter from Philadelphia. Hey, we're coming to Philadelphia next month.
Alfred
we're
going
to be there
everywhere.
Together in worship. Can't wait to meet with you. And then let's say hello to Sister Odette Florence, who's calling in. Oh, she's from Rex, Georgia.
Georgia!
Sister Florence, welcome. Glad to have all y'all with us today.
Absolutely. Welcome. And again, Pastor, thank you for being with us here on the Prelude.
I ain't got to preach today.
Yes, sir. Well, you all, you know that on the Prelude, it is Women's History Month, and we want to highlight some amazing women who have made some amazing contributions. And today, we want to honor the Reverend Faye Gunn, an important figure here at ASBC, and we want you to check out the video now.
Little did she know the imprint that she would have on the historic church and congregation when Reverend Faye Gunn joined Alfred Street Baptist Church on the first Sunday of the new year in 1971. An active member, she taught young adult Sunday school, was a member of the missionary circle, and chaired the Commission on Evangelism. 10 years later, in the spring of 1981, Reverend Faye Gunn felt a call to the ministry and spoke with her pastor, Reverend John O. Peterson, about it. She wanted to share God's gift of salvation and spread the gospel. She was obedient to the calling and was licensed to preach the gospel by Alfred Street Baptist Church on December 12, 1982, after giving her trial sermon. Alfred Street ordained her on November 23, 1984, and she served as the assistant pastor to Reverend John O. Peterson until her retirement on July 31, 2010. During this period, Faye had the distinct honor to serve as interim pastor from January 2007 through April 2008 during the search and calling of Alfred Street's eighth and current pastor, Reverend Dr. Howard John Wesley. After she served as interim pastor, she continued to lead in various capacities at Alfred Street, including as director of the Christian Education Life Institute. Reverend Dr. Gunn is recognized as a leader and has been honored several times by many for her outstanding leadership skills. She's the recipient of the James L. Anderson Award for supporting education and community projects from the Northern Virginia Urban League and the Ebony Ibbins Award for her contribution to the field of religion from the Coalition of 100 Black Women of Northern Virginia Chapter, to name a few. She was former officer and member of Jack and Jill Incorporated of America, a former Cub Scout mother, the former president of the Alpha Wives of Prince George's County, Maryland, and a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. Reverend Gunn will be remembered for her many roles on her journey here on this earth. We remember her by her motto, "Without God, she cannot do anything, but with God, she can do all things." We salute and celebrate this brilliant and beautiful woman of Alfred Street Baptist Church for Women's History Month.
Reverend Gunn, we thank you for your contributions here at the Alfred Street Baptist Church. Well, you all, it's time for worship. We are excited about the Easter pageant, and it's time. Get ready to begin service with a video featuring Trinity Choir, our children's choir, and the Helm Bear Choir. We'll see you next time.
Good morning, Alfred Street. It's worship time. Let's come before our God with joy and thanksgiving in our hearts and praise on our lips. We know that God is worthy of all our praise, and so we come to Him this morning, rejoicing in our Father's love. We know of no other worthy of all our praise. Elias Collar will lead us in our opening prayer.
Please bow with me as we go to God in prayer. Father, we thank you for all the blessings you have given us. Thank you for being with us as we, your children, lead this worship hour. Please remove all fears and nervousness from us as we tell others about you, your love, and care for us. Help us to stand boldly before you this morning as we tell the story of your giving up your life so that we may have a right to eternal life. Please forgive us for the things we have done that were not pleasing to you. Help us to follow you in all we do and say. This I pray in your name. Amen.
Our scripture for this week is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 21, verses 8 and 9. Please stand for the reading of God's words. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowd that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David's blessing is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." This is the word of God for the people of God. Please remain standing and join us at our congregational hymn, At the Cross.
Save me, Lord, 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 save me, Lord Good morning, Alfred Street. I am delighted to welcome you to our program. You honor us with your presence. Please enjoy this program as we retell the story of our Lord and Savior, as he gave up his life that we may have life. Now that's love. Please pass this love on to the person sitting next to you on both sides by simply saying, God loves you and so do I. Alfred Street, please pass this love so that everyone in the sanctuary will feel love.
Worship, and to our family and friends who connect around the world wide web to join us in making glorious the name of Jesus Christ. Grace and peace be unto each and every one of you from God who loves us as mother and father, and Jesus Christ who always and alone is our resurrected, our risen, our reigning, and our returning redeemer. Listen, if you've been sitting in worship since we began, and you haven't found a reason to smile and be grateful for this day, we're going to let you leave the sanctuary now. Because we gather this day in one of the great moments of the life of this church to hear the greatest story ever told of the death and the resurrection of Christ, and to hear it from the greatest lips you will ever hear it from, the children of the Alfred Street Baptist Church. Would you help me just thank God for this day? If you were raised in church, you should remember when you had to stand in this space. And today we come to applaud and affirm, to build the confidence and the character of a generation that knows and loves and serves Jesus Christ. It's with the joy of the Lord that we enter into this moment. We do so also by the breaking of bread and sharing in cup as we reverence and remember all that Christ sacrificed for us on the cross and all that we've inherited simply because we believed. No greater offer has ever been extended to you that cost Christ so much and costs you so little. The Bible says all we have to do is confess and believe that he died for our sins and rose again. And in that confession and belief, we are saved. We break bread and share a cup with all who've made that confession and believe that in their heart. If you did not receive the elements of the Lord's Supper when you came in today, simply wave a hand. There are deacons all around who will gladly serve you now. To our family and friends watching online, we encourage you to take hold of the bread and the cup that you will use in this moment to join with us as we remember and make sacred in reverence all that happened on the cross of Calvary. Today is Palm Sunday. We begin our journey towards that cross. I was sharing with our 8 o'clock service that I got into a debate this week with someone who argued with me that we are somewhat out of order because we worship on Sunday when the Sabbath is really Friday to Saturday night. I want to share with you what I shared with him. One, I'm just glad that you worship. You can pick the day you want. I'm just grateful that you love the Lord enough to set aside time to give God what God is worthy of. But the reason we worship on Sundays, for those who are not familiar with the tradition, is because Sunday is the day that Christ rose from the dead. And when our faith began, we worshiped on that day because literally in Christian tradition, every Sunday is Easter. Every week, we remind ourselves that he died and rose. We do it formally next Sunday, but we do it in memory right now. I invite you to take hold of the bread. The bread that we eat represents the broken body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who always and alone is our Christ. Crucified, dead, buried, resurrected, ascended into heaven, sitting at the right hand of God, making intercessions for our sins, and one day to the glory of God returning. This we believe as we break bread and eat together. In the cup is a memorial of the blood shed on the cross of Calvary for the remission of our sins and the redemption of our souls. For what can wash away my sins? Nothing other than the blood of Jesus. Let us drink together. Will you pray with me? God of amazing love, we receive through our faith what you offer to us in your grace, the complete forgiveness of every sin for which we repent, the eternal security of our soul salvation and our home in heaven, the precious indwelling of the Holy Spirit to convict and guide us into a life that is pleasing in your sight, and the awesome opportunity we have to change the world as we share your transformative love with others, making more disciples. As you have forgiven us, may we learn to forgive one another. And in the same way you love us, may we love each other. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Today's a good day to be in the house of the Lord as once again we give thanks to God for the coming together of all of our children's ministries, from Kid Street to our Junior Gospel Inspirers, to the Jackie Henry Green Orchestra, to our liturgical dance. Today is a good day to celebrate our children, and we thank the Lord not only for all of those who've helped prepare them, all of our volunteers who work with them throughout the year, all the parents who made certain that they said their lines correctly and articulately. Thank you so much, brothers and sisters. Listen, I want to recognize very quickly, if one of these children is yours, if we've got parents in the house, grandparents, we want to recognize them. All the parents, if you know yours is up here, come on, stand. I want to recognize you all for bringing your children and raising them in the house of faith. Praise the Lord. Amen. We want to welcome our guests today. We know that whenever children are on stage, grandparents are in the audience. And we thank the Lord our God for all the family. If you're not a member of our church, but you don't mind us recognizing you, would you just wave a hand in the air as we thank God for all of our guests? If you've got a hand raised next to you, help me welcome them on today to our church family. God bless you and welcome. We celebrate the gift of life at Alfred Street, starting with our birthdays. If we have anyone today who's celebrating a recent birthday, would you please stand and allow us to see God's grace on your life? Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to all of you. And finally, we recognize the gift of God's love in our marriages. If we have any couples that are celebrating another year together, would you please stand and remain standing that we can celebrate with you? Any anniversaries in Alfred Street today? Anniversaries, anniversaries. Amen. Here we go. If you remain standing, you know we like to celebrate how many years. So starting in the back, my brother, my sister, how many years you all celebrating? 9. Congratulations on your 9th anniversary today. How many years you all celebrating? 9. Amen. Congratulations on your 9th anniversary. Amen. Anybody got a new boo? New boo? New boo? Okay. All right. All right. Well, you know, God is able. Family, as we go into this week of Holy Week, you know all the things that happen. We really do speed up, but we slow down. We get busy, but we do it in a way that allows us to really contemplate on all that it means to be disciples of Christ. Jesus said it like this: if anyone wants to follow me, take up your cross, deny yourself, and follow me. We embrace that message during Holy Week. We remind you that every morning this week, during Holy Week, our prayer hour at 7 a.m., I'll be glad to lead our prayers every day. I invite you to join us on our Zoom line for our prayers on 7 o'clock every morning. We have our midday devotionals this week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. We follow the footsteps of Jesus and invite you to either join us in this space or online for our noonday devotionals. They're just a half hour long, but we're led in time of contemplation of the very events that happened in Jesus' life in the final week on his way to Calvary. Thursday, we will gather at 1 p.m. and at 6 p.m. For our ordinance of foot washing. I invite you to come in with us as myself, our ministers, our deacons, humble ourselves, wash the feet of those who want to join in with us to commemorate the very act of what Jesus did with his disciples in the upper room. Friday is Good Friday. We go to the cross to hear the 7 last sayings of Jesus. And it's our tradition to let the sisters proclaim that because the sisters were there at the cross. So I invite you to come with us on this Friday at noon for our 7 last words. Saturday is Silent Saturday. All we do is get ready for Sunday. Sunday, the Bible says that Jesus rose on that first day of the week. And if you're Baptist, we don't just say he rose on Sunday. I'm going to test your Baptist. We say he rose. If your neighbor didn't know that, tell him you'll help him afterwards. If you don't know early Sunday morning, we're going to indoctrinate you to be Baptist. Early Sunday morning, we have sunrise service, 6 a.m., right here at Alfred Street Baptist Church. Then we go to Strathmore for the glorious celebration of the resurrection of Jesus. The doors open at 10, service begins at 11. And we invite you to join in with us in both those spaces, live and online, as God would give you the opportunity to be here with us. We're grateful to God that we are led in all of our aspects of worship by our children today. It's my joy to bring forth Salima and Evan, who are going to lead us in our offering and our prayer. And then we give with joy as we continue on. Won't you say amen for our children as they come to lead us on this day?
Tells me that it is more blessed to give than to receive. God gives to us all the time. We try to follow his examples and give. Here at my church, we give freely, just because we want to do as God tells us. We don't take up a collection, but we still give. Look at the screen, and you will see all the ways you can give. You decide which way is best for you. What you give is up to you and God. Evan Walker will lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Our Father, thank you for all you have given to us. We give back to you because we love you and want to do as you told us. Please bless us and the offering we freely give. Amen.
For Mary heard her name and saw the living.
The scripture for our program is found in the book of Luke. We will read from the 19th chapter, verses 41 through 44. If you're able to do so, please stand for the reading of God's word. As he came near and saw the city, he wept over it, saying, "If you, even you, had only recognized on this day the things that make for peace, but now they're hidden from your eyes. Indeed, the days will come upon you when your enemies will set up ramparts around you and surround you and hem you in on every side. They will crush you to the ground, you and your children within you, and they will not leave within once you one stone upon another, because you did not recognize the time of your visitation from God." This is the word of God for the people of God. You may be seated.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, as we bow to pray, please open the hearts and minds of your people who will receive this message and your children who will present it. Bless us all that we may know and grow in your will for us. It is in the name of Jesus that I lift up this prayer. Amen. Mary of Bethany, Judas Iscariot, council members, a false witness, Peter, a servant girl, Pilate's wife, Pilate, Simon of Cyrene, Jesus' mother Mary, and John. Come now with me. I think I hear a crowd coming this way. Wow, it looks like they're really excited. They're waving palms and shouting Hosanna!
The title of this poem is "The Little Palm Branch." I am a little palm branch. I am waving in the air, saying Jesus is coming in all his glory.
I am waving in the air.
Jesus is coming to save you and me.
I am waving in the air.
Yes, I'm a little palm branch.
I am waving for Jesus. Won't you join me?
Thank you.
difficult ruler because I follow the rules to the letter of the law. Failure to adhere to the law should follow up with punishment. Unfortunately, my job is difficult because so many people like to find the way around the law. I know some say that Jesus has not broken the law, but I know he has.
We know he has broken the law. Of course he has.
Many believe that I'm a difficult ruler because I follow the rules to the letter of the law. Failure to adhere to the law should follow up with punishment. Unfortunately, my job is difficult because so many people like to find the way around the law. I know some say that Jesus has not broken the law, but I know he has.
We know he has broken the law. Of course he has.
He goes around preaching and teaching all this stuff, which is really just magic tricks. And this is against the law. Whoever heard of a withered hand being made whole just because someone touched it?
What are we going to do about it?
The best thing to do is get rid of this Jesus before we have a riot from the people. We must plot to get rid of him now. Well, we must be careful too, because we don't want to start a protest during the Feast of the Passover. Well, trust me, I'll find a way to take Jesus down. All right, there we go.
Welcome to my home. I'm glad you decided to dine with me.
Greetings, all. My name is Mary of Bethany, and I have followed Jesus ever since I met him at my home with my sister Martha and brother Lazarus. I was disappointed when he did not come right away. My brother Lazarus died. My sister Martha was disappointed too. She told Jesus,
"Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him."
Jesus told my sister, "Your brother will rise again." I learned that whenever Jesus shows up, he is on time. My brother's body was decaying and smelled awful. Yet Jesus rose him from the dead. I know some think Jesus practices sorcery, but believe me, he does not. His power is from God alone. I have followed him, and I know he is all about love and care of us all. I could not help pouring oil on Jesus' feet after all he has done for me and my family.
The room grew still as she made her way to Jesus. She stumbles through the tears that made her blind. She felt such pain. Some spoke in anger, heard folks whisper, there's no place here for her kind. Still on she came, through the shame that flushed her face, until at last she knelt before his feet. And though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard. As she poured her love for the master from her box of alabaster, and I've come to pour my praise on him like oil from Mary's alabaster vase. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair. You weren't there the night he found me. You did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his love all around me. And you don't know the cost of the oil in my alabaster pot. I can't forget the way life used to be. I was a prisoner to the sin that had me bound. Poured my life without measure into a little treasure box I thought I found. Until the day when Jesus came to me and healed my soul with the wonder of his touch. So now I'm giving back to him praise he's worthy of. I've been forgiven, and that's why I love him so much. And I've come to pour my praise on him like oil from Mary's alabaster box. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and dry them with my hair. You are there. The night Jesus found me, you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his loving arms around me. Oil. Oh, you don't
My name is Judas Iscariot, but some call me that greedy disciple. They say that because I allowed my greed to get the best of me. I betrayed my Jesus for 30 pieces of silver.
We will give you 30 pieces of silver for such a betrayal. We think that's fair.
At the time, it seemed like a fortune, since all I did was follow Jesus and do what I was told. My love of money convinced me that I should seize the opportunity to make money, since Jesus did not give us any. Little did I know I was buying trouble and mental torment. Everything just seemed so simple. Since Jesus is so powerful, surely he would not suffer harm. Well, the truth is, I became possessed with handing Jesus over to the chief priest and his council.
The title of this poem is Betrayed. Betrayed is such a mean word. It causes discord as it, like a sword, disconnects what is enjoined in unity. How awful to be caught up in acts of betrayal when all you ever received was love. Oh, what a miserable one I have become. What a wretched soul. I am undone.
I've been a faithful member of the council since my appointment a few years ago. I am known for upholding the law and keeping our government free from condemnation. However, after much discussion, finally, the chief priest for putting Jesus under the oath of God, saying,
"Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God."
Jesus said,
"It is as you say." From now on, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power, coming down on the clouds of heaven.
What manner of answer was this? It was at this moment that the chief priest lost his cool, tore his clothes, and said, "He has blasphemed. Why do we still need to witness anymore? What is your verdict?" They answered, "He deserves death."
He deserves death.
If you asked me, this charge is a made-to-order charge by the desire of the high priest, as a chief priest. As for me, I know better than to go against the chief priest, even if I know it's wrong.
Who be a witness for my Lord? 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 Yeah, I'll be a witness for my Lord. 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 There was a man of the Pharisees. His name was Nicodemus, and he didn't believe. The same came to Christ by night, wanted to be taught out of human sight. Nicodemus was a man who desired to know, how can a man be born when he's old? Christ told Nicodemus as a friend, man, you must be born again. He said, marvel not, man. He said, marvel not, man, if you wanna be wise, repent, believe, and be baptized. Who be a witness for my Lord? Who be a witness for my Lord? Who be a witness for my Lord? Who be a witness for my Lord?
I am one of the false witnesses that condemn this Jesus. To tell you the truth, I followed the rest of those who said what the priest expected to hear. But what followed, our response was terrible. We spat in Jesus' face, and some of us even slapped him in his face. We all cursed his power, saying, prophesy to us, you Messiah. Who is it that struck you? I felt terrible after I did this, and will never fully understand why. Just think, I condemned an innocent man for no reason at all.
The title of this poem is For No Reason At All. How many things do we do?
For no reason at all.
How many suffer?
For no reason at all.
How many lose their lives?
For no reason at all.
To act for no reason is a dangerous thing.
That corrupts the soul only to be left with sin.
Oh, may I act for this one reason.
But to live eternally with him.
Pageant servant girl was right there when those witnesses at the court spat, slapped, and mocked Jesus as if he was a toy. I saw it all. But of course, I cannot speak because I am a woman, and a woman has no right to speak about or correct the actions of a man. However, I guess I took a chance this one time. I asked this man sitting outside the courtyard if he knew this Jesus. His response did not surprise me. He denied ever knowing Jesus, yet I am positive I have seen him with Jesus many, many times. It was a time of run and hide. I wasn't the only one who recognized this man as a follower of Jesus. Many of my fellow servant girls asked him the same question.
Were you with Jesus? I know I saw you with him. You were one of his disciples.
This man became so angry, he began to curse and swear an oath, saying,
I keep telling you and telling you and telling you, I do not know the man.
Wow, what a scene. Just then, a cock crowed three times. I guess even the lowly cocks knew that something was not right. Oh well, I wonder what will happen next.
I am Pilate's wife, and I love my husband dearly. I don't want any ill to harm him. I could not sleep well last night because of an unsettling dream I had about him. In my dream, I was told to warn my husband to have nothing to do with the death of this innocent man. I'm not allowed to speak in court. How will I get this message to him?
I will find a way to get the message to your husband for you, Your Highness.
I sent a messenger with this message to Pilate. It said, have nothing to do with the death of this innocent man. For today, I have suffered a great deal because of a dream I had about him.
I have a message from your wife, sir. She says, have nothing to do with the death of that innocent man.
Nonetheless, the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowd to ask for Barabbas and kill Jesus. All I can say is I kept my husband's hand clean of the guilt of killing an innocent man.
am Pontius Pilate, the ruler of the court. After my wife's warning, I knew I should have nothing to do with the killing I am Pontius Pilate, the ruler of the court. After my wife's warning, I knew I should have nothing to do with the killing of this innocent man. I asked the priests, elders, and those of the crowd to give me the fault they found in Jesus. I received no other witness other than crucify him, crucify him.
Crucify him! Crucify him! Give us Barabbas! Give us Barabbas!
I became so overwhelmed with their senseless shouting that I took some water and washed my hands before the crowd, saying, I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves. Then the people shouted, his blood be on us and on our children. I released Barabbas to them. But shortly thereafter, Jesus was flogged and handed over to be crucified.
The title of this poem is Wash My Hands. Water, please. I need water to wash my hands of the senseless killing of the innocent. I need living water to make me whole. Water, water, come cleanse this heart of mine. Living water, life divine. Wash me now that I may be thine.
I am Simon of Cyrene. I guess you might say that I am a foreigner in these places. As the crowd and soldiers were leading Jesus to his place of crucifixion, I was compelled to carry Jesus' cross. Of course, I wondered why I was being singled out from all the rest. Some say it's because I am considered a foreigner in these places, while others say it's because I am dark. But regardless of the reason, my heart was filled with compassion for this man that I barely knew. The cross was indeed heavy, but somehow it did not seem to matter. I actually wanted to carry this cross. This might sound strange to you, but I was honored to carry Jesus' cross. When we reached the place of the skulls, Jesus was mocked, beaten, and scourged. A crown of thorns was placed on his head. He was crucified between two thieves.
My God, my son, oh no, my son.
I was filled with sadness. My only relief was to know that I helped him carry his cross.
Thank you.
when I saw my mother as I hung on the cross. I called out to her. I knew that I would soon leave and did not want her to be alone. I told her to look at me while I called out to my disciple John. I gave John instructions to take care of my mother. He agreed, and shortly thereafter, I knew that all would soon be finished. I bowed my head and finally cried out, "It is finished."
It is finished.
Then I gave up my spirit.
Of this poem is, I was there. I was there for everywhere Jesus went, things changed for the better.
The people who were sick became well. The people who were blind began to see. The people who were persecuted were liberated.
People who were hungry were given food and something to drink. People whose minds were possessed were set free of torment.
People who were lost, motherless, fatherless, were comforted and cared for. And I was there when he raised the dead.
I was there then, and I am there now. I am with him now. This very moment and even forevermore.
I was there! I was there! I was there!
Yeah.
Family, will you help me just thank God for these amazing children? Come on, let them know how much of a blessing they have been to us today. Praise the Lord our God. The song they just sang, Ask, Were We There? I thank the Lord that they have taken us there today. What an appropriate way to enter into Palm Sunday, into Holy Week, to prepare ourselves for the conclusion. The story doesn't end there. We know that we gather a week from today to declare the greatest victory that we've ever experienced or seen, and that in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. He died for us. And how great it is to know that they know that as well, that they know it in dance and in song and in the drama. Can you imagine how much it takes to coordinate this many young people to learn their lines, to be in the right place at the right time? Listen, it would be inappropriate for us to celebrate them and not also give thanks to God for those who volunteer their time only because they love your children and want to make certain that your children are in a safe space to learn about Jesus Christ. On the back of your programs, you'll see the names of all those volunteers. They're headed up by one of the greatest women we know, the Reverend Marla Hawkins, with her team. I'm gonna ask all of the Kids Street team, all the tech, all the volunteers, would you all stand for a moment in Alfred Street? Help me thank God for these men and women and the hours they put in to love on our children. Thank you all. The gospel comes in many forms, and it's my prayer that today it resonates in your heart with joy as you've heard it through the mouths, the songs, the music, the dance of our children. And if it's moved your heart in such a way that you would like to know Jesus Christ, that's available all the time. Immediately after our benediction, when we handle things correctly, there'll be deacons down front and in the back. If you want to join our church family today, if you want to bring your children to be part of this family, if you want to know the Lord in your own personal way, it'd be our joy to share that with you in this offer of invitation. I thank the Lord for all that's come together today with our music, with our dance, with our children, with our Kids Street, with our crossover. It is a glorious thing to be part of a church and witness young people grow in their love of Jesus Christ, to see them stand confidently before a congregation, to know that we will amen and clap until they remember that line, that we celebrate them in all ways, that if any place they ought to be affirmed, it ought to be in the house of the Lord. And I thank you, Alfred Street, for making that a reality. You never know what happens when you raise a child in church like this and you applaud and affirm them. You never know where your next pastor is going to be, where your next president is going to be, where your next congressperson is going to be, where your next school teacher is going to be. You never know what you just sowed into their lives on today. As always, we thank the Lord for those who do volunteer. And as I said, she doesn't need much of an introduction. We see her here all the time at Christmas and during this holy season. She writes and directs the entire thing. Would you put your hands together for the Reverend Marla Hawkins, who comes with her own word? Come on, Marla.
Thank you so much. The greatest blessing that anyone could ever have is to have a child near them and dear to them. And I thank every parent, grandparent, surrogate parent in this place for allowing us to work with your children. That's the real joy in serving in Kid Street, is that you get to hear children come to the place where they love God, they want to serve God, and they want to follow God for the rest of their lives. I'm grateful today, I'm excited today, for these children have poured out their hearts to us. And so I want our team and all those who work with Kid Street to turn around and tell the parents, thank you. You are special to us, and you have given us a gift that never stops giving. thank you.
Reverend Hawkins, we'd like to give you a little something to say thank you.
Reverend Hawkins, Kate Street really appreciates what you have done for us, and we wanted to present to you these beautiful flowers because you are special.
Teach a young man how to give a woman flowers. Amen. That, praise the Lord. Listen, family, here's what's about to happen so that we can do things decently and in order. We know that parents want to rush down and take photos and grab your children, but we need to do this decently. All of our children are to come up so we can have a group photo. We're asking parents, please remain in your places. If you do, please remain where you are. After our group photo, which we're going to take quickly, Charles, our children are going downstairs. They have to turn in their costumes, and we have a special lunch and treat for them in order to say thank you and congratulate the work that they've done. And parents, you can reclaim your children from downstairs in the multi-purpose room. In just a moment, I'm going to give the benediction. Jackie Henry Green Orchestra is going to bless us with our final selection. Then we're going to call the children up. Parents are going to stay in their places. We're going to take our photo. Our children will go downstairs. They will turn in their costumes. They'll get their treats. You all can meet them downstairs to collect them. Is that all right? Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's look to the Lord as we get ready to leave this place. God, we thank you for meeting us in this space today, for the joy of children, for a safe environment where they learn about Jesus Christ, for the confidence to stand and tell the story of salvation of our Savior. For all those, Lord, who've put in the hours of practice and rehearsal and technical production, that today they may be affirmed and applauded. We thank you, O Lord, for salvation in the name of Christ. We now enter into Holy Week. We ask your blessings upon the palms that will be distributed upon our leaving, that we may carry them as more than just religious symbols, but that which indicates that our hearts too are excited about the salvation that has come. Thank you, O Lord, for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, what our hearts have felt. May we go out and share that good news and that love with others. In Jesus' name we do pray, amen.
What's up, Alpha Street family? Welcome to our online worship experience. Thank you for joining us as we continue to celebrate this season of Lent. Happy Palm Sunday! I'm Charnell King, social media manager. Let's get into our weekly announcements. Let's talk about March Gladness. Reverend R. Janae Pitts Murdoch delivered a word, y'all. In case you missed it, you can catch the full sermon on our YouTube channel. On March 26th at 7 p.m., we can't wait to welcome Reverend Dr. John R. Adel. Make sure to join us in person or online to hear and witness some powerful messages of faith. There's so many wonderful events happening during Holy Week. Let's talk about it. We want to invite everyone to join us for Holy Week devotionals. It all kicks off on Monday, March 25th at 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. There will be a different speaker each day. Join Pastor Wesley every morning during Holy Week at 7 a.m. as he will be leading us in prayer. We can't wait for you to join us for the foot washing experience on Thursday, March 28th at 1 p.m. and 6 p.m. in the multipurpose room. On Good Friday, Sisters at the Cross starts at 12 p.m. on Friday, March 29th. For more information, please visit alfredstreet.org. Our sunrise service kicks off on Sunday, March 31st at 6 a.m. And we can't wait to see you at 11 a.m. for our Easter worship service at the Strathmore in Bethesda, Maryland. Doors do open at 10 a.m. Let's stay connected. Make sure you're following along at AlfredstreetBC on all social platforms. And guess what? I'm sure you already know. You can find us now on TikTok. Now, here are the remaining upcoming announcements for this week.
We know that these are difficult and challenging times. We invite you to stay connected by participating in our online worship services and remain faithful in your giving online via our Alfred Street website, ASBC app, and on our text messaging system.
Everyone, please be sure to scan the QR code with your phone, which will take you directly to our giving page on our website.
If you have any questions about giving, please feel free to email our finance department at finance@alfredstreet.org. If you're interested in becoming a member of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, please email deacons with an S at alfredstreet.org or complete the membership form on our website or on our ASBC app.
Our daily prayer call was a huge success during SEEK 2024, thanks in part to all of you. As a result, we'll resume our daily prayer call starting on Monday, February 26th at 7 a.m. Eastern Time. However, we will continue to utilize the Zoom platform that we've used during SEEK 2024. Please visit our website, social media platforms, and/or eBlast for additional information. We invite everyone to download your free copy of the ASBC 2024 Lenten Devotional Brochure. It's now available online via our website. We love our Alfred Street kids. Get ready for the 2024 Children's Easter Pageant entitled I Was There, written by our very own Reverend Marla C. Hawkins. This will all take place in person and live stream on Sunday, March 24th on our YouTube channel and Facebook Live during our 11 a.m. Palm Sunday worship experience. Join us and the Kid Street Ministry to see and hear about Jesus from our kids.
Alfred Street would like to invite everyone to join us online and or in person during Holy Week, March 25th through March 29th. Our Holy Week midday devotionals will commence on Monday, March 25th at 12 p.m. noon Eastern Time with Minister Otis Byrd Jr. On Tuesday, March 26th, Minister Paul Hippolyte. And on Wednesday, March 27th is Minister Errol Moore. And closing out the midday devotionals will be Minister Andrea Pippins. Attention Alfred Street family and friends, we want to invite everyone to attend our foot washing experience in person at Alfred Street Baptist Church on Monday, Thursday, March 28th at 1 p.m. immediately following our noon meditations and again at 6 p.m. in the evening. No registration needed. Just show up. Alfred Street family and friends, tell everyone you know to meet you at Alfred Street Baptist Church on March 29th, Good Friday at 12 p.m. noon Eastern Time. Come out and experience in person and or online the Sisters at the Cross. Seven dynamic women of the gospel will deliver the seven last words of Jesus Christ in the most unique way. You definitely want to be in the sanctuary to experience these seven powerful women. They are as follows. The first word will be given by Reverend Marla C. Hawkins. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Luke 23:34. The second word will be delivered by Reverend Dr. Zena Jacques. Surely I say to you, today you shall be with me in paradise. Luke 23:43. The third word will be presented by Reverend Marcia Norfleet. Woman, behold thy son. Behold your mother. John 19:26 and 27. The fourth word will be given by Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan. My God, why have you forsaken me? Matthew 27 and 46. The fifth word will be delivered by Reverend Dr. Rosalind M. Brock. I thirst. John 19:28. The sixth word will be brought to you by Minister Jessica Anderson. It is finished. John 19:30. And finally, the seventh word will be given by Reverend Dr. Siobhan Arline Bradley. Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. Luke 23:46. This will be an amazing worship experience. We look forward to seeing everyone in the sanctuary and or online on Good Friday, March 29th at 12 p.m. noon. Alfred Street family, be sure to make plans now to worship with us online and or in person on Palm Sunday on March 24th at 8 and 11 a.m. Eastern Time. We will be distributing palms on Palm Sunday as well. Please come out and support our Kid Street Easter worship experience on Palm Sunday as well on March 24th during the 11 a.m. worship service. We look forward to seeing you there.
We also invite everyone to join us live in person at 6 a.m. Eastern Time for our annual Easter Sunrise Worship Experience. It'll all take place in the sanctuary at Alfred Street Baptist Church, located at 301 South Alfred Street in Alexandria, Virginia, on Resurrection Sunday, March 31st. Again, that's 6 a.m. Eastern Time. Holy Week will culminate with our Easter Sunday Resurrection services on March 31st, which will again be held at the Music Center at Strathmore in North Bethesda, Maryland. We encourage you to please visit our alfredstreet.org website to view the entire 2024 Holy Week schedule and list of events, as well as any additional information related to Holy Week and Easter.
DMV, get ready. Join us in person and or online at the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, home to the Reverend Dr. Howard John Wesley, as we close out our spectacular 2024 March Gladness Spring Revival, happening every Tuesday at 7 p.m. throughout the month of March. Alfred Street's 2024 Spring Revival features some of the most dynamic speakers in the nation. On Tuesday, March 26th at 7 p.m., Alfred Street welcomes the incredible Reverend Dr. John R. Adolph of the Antioch Missionary Baptist Church in Beaumont, Texas. Doors open at 6 p.m. and the revival experience starts at 7 p.m. If you want to be rejuvenated and revived, join us at Alfred Street Baptist Church, 301 South Alfred Street in Alexandria, Virginia, on Tuesday, March 26th at 7 p.m. for our 2024 March Gladness Spring Revival. Visit alfredstreet.org for more details. That's alfredstreet.org.
Alfred Street Baptist Church Community. From the Office of Christian Care and Counseling, Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan, LPC, March Awareness is about parents and parenting. Parenting is a journey that lasts a lifetime. Families are the most important institution, the most important resource in a child's life. As parents, our role is essential in shaping the well-being of our children. Every parent wants to be a good parent, and I'm sure you've asked yourself many times, what is the blueprint for being a parent? How am I supposed to do this? As Christians, there's really only one blueprint for how to live our lives, and this blueprint includes how to parent our children. The blueprint is the Bible. The Bible expresses roles, realities, and responsibilities of parents. Jesus shares with us the principles he asks of his followers, and these apply to parenting as well. We should follow God's example of what it means to love his children. Check out this month's article, Parenting, Is There a Blueprint? By Michelle Johnson, ASBC Parent Coach. Visit our website and or our Office of Christian Care and Counseling webpage for helpful links and more information on parenting. Visit our webpage, alfredstreet.org/OCCC, or email pastoralcounseling@alfredstreet.org. Attention all high school seniors of Alfred Street Baptist Church. It's that time of year. The 2024 ASBC High School Senior Scholarship applications are now being accepted online, calling all parents and guardians of high school seniors to visit our website. Complete the application today. More detailed information can be found on our website. The application deadline is May 15th, so don't wait. Please complete your application today. Speaking of grief, Alfred Street's Office of Christian Care and Counseling, in conjunction with our Grief Share Ministry, presents their 2024 Spring Sessions, starting on March 14th through June 13th, and every Thursday night, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. This will be a virtual online experience. You must register online to receive the webinar information. Remember, grief is a natural, complex, and emotional response to loss. The Grief Share sessions are a great support system. Email griefshare@alfredstreet.org for details.
Pastor Wesley's pick for our March Book of the Month is Medgar and Merle. Medgar Evers and the Love Story That Awakened America by author Joyanne Reed. This number one New York Times bestseller by MSNBC's Joyanne Reed is a triumphant work of biography that repositioned slain civil rights pioneer Medgar Evers at the heart of America's struggle for freedom and celebrates Merle Evers' extraordinary activism after her husband's assassination in the driveway of their Mississippi home. Be sure to pick up a copy of this book from your favorite retailer.
Hey everybody, I'm Minister Otis Byrd Jr. and it's my honor to serve as the assistant to the pastor for online ministry and engagement here at the Alfred Street Baptist Church. And guess what? I have some exciting news to share with you. I'm glad you asked. It's our new live pre-worship broadcast, The Prelude. I got you. Every Sunday morning, we will go live reporting from inside the walls of ASBC to inform you of what's going on in these Alfred streets, to intentionally engage with our faithful online viewers, and just to have some fun together before worship service begins. It will begin airing on Sunday, February 4th. Online viewers, get ready to interact with us live in the chat. Get ready to share with us your name, your city, and any other comments you'd like to share with us. We are excited about this endeavor, and we hope to see you there.
Are you looking for an incredible opportunity to share your musical talents? If so, look no further. Alfred Street Sanctified Symphony Orchestra is thrilled to announce that they are recruiting talented musicians like you to join their harmonious family. They're calling for all musicians to join them every Friday evening from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Send an email to sanctifiedsymphony@alfredstreet.org if interested. They can't wait to welcome you into the Alfred Street Baptist Church Sanctified Symphony Orchestra.
Hey, Alfred Street, Verses is back in stock. Our Verses team has been working around the clock to create another batch of our popular Verses Bible-based trivia card game, and they're now available for purchase. That's right, purchase your set of Verses cards today before we sell out again. Visit our website or ASBC app and be the first to get your hands on Verses, a Bible-based trivia game by Alfred Street Baptist Church.
Alfred Street's Office of Christian Care and Counseling, in conjunction with the Health and Well-Being Recovery Ministry, present a bi-weekly peer support session virtually via Zoom. That's every first and third Wednesday from 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Visit our website for the Zoom link information. The Recovery Ministry peer support sessions will provide a safe and confidential environment to confront addictions, compulsive behaviors, and issues that interfere with a renewed relationship with God. Email recovery@alfredstreet.org for details. Calling all parents and guardians of children, youth, and teens. Alfred Street's Children and Youth Ministries are back. We're currently accepting registrations for Kid Street, Crossover, and Higher Ground. Visit our website to register your child or youth today. Alfred Street invites everyone to join the Joyce K. Peterson Handbell Ringers. They are thrilled to announce that their ensemble recruitment is now open. If you have a passion for music and a heart for worship, we invite you to be a part of this harmonious journey. If you can read music and are eager to contribute your talents to a musical ministry that touches souls, this is your moment to shine. For more info and to express your interest, please email handbell@alfredstreet.org.
Our Faye Savage Gunn Tutorial Ministry has a new home online. Communicate, learn, and stay informed all in one place. Visit our new webpage and check us out today at alfredstreet.org. Email tutorial@alfredstreet.org for details.
Our ASBC Village Study Guide is now available on the website to download. Be sure to check out a copy if you want to go deeper with Pastor Wesley's sermon prepared for you by the Villages of Alfred Street team. The guide is available online at alfredstreet.org. Hey, Alfred Street family and friends. Are you visiting us for the very first time? Or perhaps you're new to Alfred Street and you want to stay connected to us or receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text? If so, all visitors, text the word visitors with an S to our new direct text number, 571-977-4525. That's 571-977-4525.
Also, we invite you to tune in to our Faith Forward weekly radio broadcast featuring Pastor Howard John Wesley every Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Magic 102.3 FM and 92.7 FM for a powerful sermon that will move you forward in your faith.
We want to thank you for tuning into Alpha Street's live worship experience. Again, this is Charnell King, Social Media Manager. For more information on what's happening here at Alpha Street, make sure to check out our website and social media platforms. We hope you have a blessed week.